Hi guys, and welcome back to my next video. In this video we will be discussing how to calculate an unknown resistor. What you can see here is the fact that we pretty much have a parallel series circuit here. The only thing that I've changed is the fact that we have an unknown resistor there, which is my Rx. Now what I've seen, what students do is they are too concentrated on Rx, which means they don't know actually what to do and how to start by solving a circuit like this. All right, so I'm going to go step by step through the circuit and how you will use the values that you have to calculate a circuit like this. All right, first and foremost, I'm just going to make marks where we have the known value so that you can see that the known values which we actually have in the circuit when I have an Rx. So let's say my total voltage, which we have here, is a known voltage, a known value. My I total is a known value. R1, R3 is a known value, and then R4 is a known value. All right. So everywhere we have made a mark is known value. So just keep that in mind when I do the calculations or when I tell you what formulas to use. Alright, so this circuit basically works like the following. If you can say, if I can make an example, if you want to be a millionaire, if we can make that example, you can't just sit around at home dreaming you want to be a millionaire. You need to start somewhere to be able to become a millionaire. And that's the same principle that you will use in a circuit like this. You need to start somewhere to be able to get to that point of Rx. And the way you will start is by looking around X, seeing what you have around X, because you have known values. So that known values can be used, although the first known value or the first formula that you're going to use is not necessarily going to give you Rx, but you are starting at a point and you're getting somewhere. So that is the approach that you need to take when you are calculating or solving a problem like this. All right, so the first thing that we can see, or the first thing that I can see, is that I have a V total here, I have I total. So the first thing that I can calculate is R total. Is R total gonna give me Rx? No, it's not, but I'm starting somewhere. So R total is equals to my total voltage divided by my total current. So there I have already calculated something. All right. The next thing that I can calculate is, keep in mind, what is the rules, right? Or what is the laws? Kirchhoff's current law, Kirchhoff's voltage law. If we use Kirchhoff's voltage law, we can say that that resistor which I have here is in series with my battery, which means the current flowing through that resistor stays the same until it's reached that point where it splits. So which means I can calculate the voltage drop V1 over resistor 1, because I have a total current flowing through that resistor and I have the known value of that specific R1. So which means, in actual fact, is that V1 is going to be equals to my I total times R1. That is what V1's gonna be. Alright. Next, I can calculate, if I have a look at and I say to myself, right, I have a V1 here, I have the total voltage here. If current flows through that resistor, my current splits. When the current gets to the other side, it is again going to be my I total. And now I'm using Kirchhoff's current law to find out that. So which means I'm going to have I total here. That is what I'm going to have. Which means I can actually calculate what is the voltage drop over R4. And my voltage drop over R4 is going to be V3 is equals to I total times R4. And there I have what is the voltage there. Right, I'm just gonna, no, let's just leave it like that. I'm not gonna say that's known voltages now. I'm just gonna leave it like that. The next thing that I can say is, right, if I have those two and I have my total voltage, to get the voltage here, I can now use Kirchhoff's voltage law to calculate what is V2. So now I say that my V total is equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. The voltage that I need is V2. So I must make V2 the subject of my formula. And V2 is equals to V total minus the sum of V1 plus V3. And there I have what is my V2. My voltage V2. And now you can see you haven't calculated Rx yet, but you're getting somewhere. You're getting the values of the voltages and so on. Alright. The next thing that you can calculate, or that you will be able to calculate, is the fact that this current here, I2, can now be calculated. Why? Because I have V2, it's a known value now. I have R3, which is already a known value given in the beginning. So I can calculate the current. Remember, you only need two of these to calculate the third one. Right. So now I can say that I2 is now going to be equals to a voltage divided by a resistance, which means now I have what is the value of I2. Right, so I'm getting somewhere. The next thing that I can do is I can see, right, my total current is flowing towards that point there, which means the current splits that way and that way. So if I have this, I can now use Kirchhoff's current law to calculate that, because I have the total current and I have my I2. So now my total current, Kirchhoff's current law says I total is equals to I1 plus I2 in the case of this circuit, because I only have the two currents that split there. So now I can say, right, I need I1. So I must make I1 the subject of my formula. I1 is equals to I total minus I2. And there I get, what is my current I1 flowing through Rx? And now you can say, right, because I have I1 now, and I have the voltage drop V2 over this resistor and that Rx, the unknown resistor, that I can now calculate what is the value of that unknown resistor. And your final formula will look like this. I1 then is equals to my, sorry, not I1, I've made a mistake here, sorry guys. Now I can say Rx is equals to my V2 divided by my current I1, and there I have what is my unknown, the value of my unknown resistor in this specific circuit. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel for more of these interesting videos. Thank you very much.